So, normally when game news happens, I make a little short video. I post a minute-long rundown of all the news of the day, and I move on. But with E3 and the Summer Games Fest, it quickly became apparent that this strategy doesn't always work that well. There was a lot of news, and I'd have to skip a lot of things. And also, Ratchet and Clank came out, and I was playing that, and I didn't feel like making a video every day. But now that E3 is over, I get to sit here and go through all of the stuff that I procrastinated on.
Eyes wide, palms are sweaty. The Flintstones on the TV already. Wilma and Betty.
Overall, it was a show. From a new Borderlands spinoff to some nice indie titles and a few crossover episodes. It was fun all around. Death Stranding Director's Cut is kind of expected. I mean, the game got released with visual improvements on the PC, and so an upgraded version only makes sense. The end of the show was Elden Ring, which has garnered quite a bit of hype. It's the next Souls-like Souls game, but it has the help from the Game of Thrones guy, and people got excited, and it looks cool, whatever. If I had to give this show a score, I'd say it was fine out of 10.
Eyes wide, palms are sweaty, the Flintstones on the TV already, Wilma and Betty.
Ubisoft has a weird history with announcements. I mean, a few high-profile games have just been announced with a CGI trailer or an in-engine trailer, and then they disappear off the face of the earth. Does anybody remember Skull and Bones? I didn't expect any of these far-off games to appear, and they didn't. The show is actually missing quite a few things. No new Assassin's Creed or Rayman, but what we got was mostly fine. Far Cry 6 looks great, but we've seen it a lot. Enough that I think they can just, you can take a break. We don't need to see anymore. We know it exists. It has a doggy. Riders Republic, I do care about, and I was happy to see gameplay and a release date. Extraction could be a big hit, but it's hard to say until it's actually out, so I won't say. A new Rabbids game. I don't like these things. I just don't like looking at them. The big announcement at the end of the show, the announcement that's garnered quite a lot of, not hype, but conversation, has been Avatar, the game. It's by the Division developers, which doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be good or bad, but most people aren't talking about that. Most people are interested in the fact that this property, this franchise, is a franchise. I mean, think about it. One film, 2009, it raked in a lot of cash, a lot of people don't look back on it too fondly, and now we have three sequels to look forward to. This game exists to tie into that sequel, so, you know.
Eyes wide, palms are sweaty, the Flintstones on the TV already, Wilma and Betty.
Devolver Digital consistently makes the most entertaining E3 conferences. It's a long-running parody of the tropes and expectations of E3, and it's always a good time. Last year, they released a game as their E3 show, and it was the best meta conference you could possibly ask for. So this year, I expected, you know, it's good. It's always good. You got new Shadow Warrior 3 footage, and a bunch of new titles, and I bought this game that's physical only because, you know, this sounds cool. And before I get to the big shows, let's talk about a weird trend that started this year. Companies that would hold a conference, but not really hold a conference. See, in years past, it used to cost quite a lot of money to go to E3. So companies that didn't have anything to show or didn't have enough to show would not hold a conference. Now that it's digital, any company can just have a show and hope people watch. What this means is some less savory companies put out effectively ads for the company and try to build brand identity in this weird manipulative corporate sense. And out of this bunch of non-shows, Square was the closest to being a real show, I guess, with Deus Ex style Guardians of the Galaxy. It looks like a good time. I don't like these IP crossovers. I don't want more Marvels or Star Wars or Avatar games, but it looks fun. But now, on to the big ones.
Eyes wide, palms are sweaty, the Flintstones on the TV already, Wilma and Betty.
You gotta remember that Xbox Game Studios, much like Ubisoft, has shown many games that just never resurfaced. Stuff that's been announced so early in development that 3 years later, we still haven't seen anything. Some of these games have just restarted development in the meantime, leading me to question, why show it in the first place? The only thing that was a given was Halo Infinite had to be there, and Starfield should probably be there. And as the conference started, well, we got Starfield. We got a CGI trailer, which is, it's fine. It's still pretty far out. 11/11/22, which is a, it's a fun nod to Skyrim. Yeah. The big news for me was the confirmation of a new engine, because Bethesda really needed that. You know, Elder Scrolls 6 is still quite a ways off, but they gave fans the location of the next game scribbled into this control panel, which was a very nice, very Bethesda touch. Besides this, there was a lot there. Atomic Heart, which has been a NVIDIA RTX tech demo for the most part for a long time, got a good trailer. And alongside that, it's visually clear that many next-gen games are actively in development finally. We're moving away from the cross-gen period, hopefully soon. Outer Worlds 2 was the self-deprecating, we are a CGI trailer, but here it is, which is appreciated. Forza Motorsport is not releasing this year, instead replaced with Horizon. Now, I saw this game rumored for an appearance quite a while before the show, so it wasn't the most shocking thing, but it's cool nonetheless. Visually, it looks great, but I do hope that ray tracing on cars is a feature enabled on the PC version, because, you know, I want more ray tracing. And of course, the big boy, Halo Infinite. This was a weird showing. It wasn't that long, and we've almost exclusively seen the multiplayer, with a very, very brief glance at the campaign mode. Supposedly, this is releasing in 2021, with the vague holiday 2021 moniker. I do not believe this. I think it will be split up or something like that, and I'll talk about that more in my other vid. The closing Arcane game at the end could be good, but again, it was a CGI trailer. If anything, it was more of an indication by Microsoft that Bethesda games, large and small, will be Xbox exclusive. Overall, my favorite announcement was actually Slime Rancher 2, because just look at those slimes.
Eyes wide, palms are sweaty, the Flintstones on the TV already!
Nintendo usually disappoints me on every conference, but overall, pound for pound, what we got was very good. Mario Party is back in Mario form. WarioWare is back in Wario form. Advance Wars is getting remade. The Monkey Ball game that was leaked by Nick Robinson is a thing. Breath of the Wild 2 and Mario Golf still exists. Considering Nintendo still has Pokemon games coming out at the end of the year and early next year, I don't feel too let down that we didn't get a new Donkey Kong or a Mario Kart. I would have been fine with this, but having a new 2D Metroid game after so many years, that's a real surprise. And Nintendo doesn't often surprise me. In a good way, that is. I mean, it wasn't all good news. There was a lot missing. No Virtual Console or 64 Classic. Mario is still dead. Splatoon 3, where's the Splatoon? Metroid Prime 4 is still a far ways out. The biggest thing that was missing, though, to me at least, was the Switch Pro. You've seen the rumors and the memes, and now the E3s is here, and the Switch Pro isn't. I will talk about this much more in my Nintendo video, but for the time being, you know, let's forget about it. Overall, I think it was a good show, which for Nintendo is a rare thing, which means it was a great show. Out of all the conferences, we had fine and good and the worst ever. But considering that we are right after the unproductive year that was 2020, I think overall, you know, it's to be expected. I mean, if this is the great video game drought that comes from that 2020, you know, thing, if this is the worst it gets, then that's not too bad at all. And while we never get everything we want, this was good enough. That's what I rank this E3. It was good enough.